cold floors, freezing pipes, high energy bills. You know it's time to upgrade your insulation and your crawl space, but what are your best options? Hi, I'm Gary, an estimator at RetroFoam of Michigan. Let's discuss and compare the most common types of insulation found in a crawl space, fiberglass and spray foam. Fiberglass is a more traditional type of insulation found in attics, walls, and crawl spaces in many older homes. The most commonly used form of fiberglass found in crawl spaces is blankets, which are batts and rolls. Fiberglass is good for standard stud and joist spacing for a crawl space and is the least expensive insulation material for that area. It can even be a DIY project for an experienced homeowner who isn't afraid of tight areas and getting dirty. On the flip side, fiberglass allows for airflow, which is a major source of cold floors, uncomfortable homes, and high energy bills. It can also trap allergens, dust, and moisture in the crawl space, which can promote the growth of mold and mildew. Old, dirty, and ineffective fiberglass can be removed from the crawl space and replaced with new insulation. The ideal option would be to first air seal all the gaps and cracks before installing new fiberglass, but this extra step adds major expense and time to the project. Spray foam can be used in open areas like the attic, crawl space, and rim joist. Spray foam is further divided into open cell and closed cell foam insulation. We usually recommend an open cell spray foam for this type of application, but there are circumstances when closed cell spray foam is a better option for the crawl space. Spray foam doesn't retain water, so it doesn't promote mold and mildew growth. Foam insulation is also an air barrier material, stopping cold from making its way into the crawl space, which makes your home more comfortable. Because of its superior benefits, it's the most effective option for solving insulation-related problems in the home, but comes with the highest initial cost. It is often too complex for a successful DIY project as well. Any old insulation from the crawl space would need to be removed before spray foam is applied. Most contractors will do this dirty work as well as dispose of the old insulation. So which insulation type is best for your crawl space? That's really up for you to decide. If you are looking for the cheapest way out, removing the old traditional insulation and replacing with new fiberglass should help for the time being. However, if you really want to transform your home's comfort and improve those cold floors and freezing pipes, spray foam is the better long-term solution. I wish you the best with your crawl space insulation journey. If you're still looking for more information, check out our learning center at the link below.